Everyone, welcome to the channel. Now to understand the concepts very clearly, please watch the video till the end. Once you are done with watching the video, please do not forget to like, comment, subscribe and hit the bell icon. Today we are going to see some most frequently used SaaS options. What are those most frequently used SaaS options? These are six most frequently used SaaS options while we are doing the manipulation in data, right? There are a couple of modes, there are many modes in fact, but these six are most frequently used. These are mainly used with data steps, so we also call them data options. Now let's go ahead and check each one of these one by one. In SAS we have a library named SAS help which contains a table cars, which looks like this. Now we're gonna try first option, which is called keep, and out of this table we want to produce this kind of table which has only three columns. Now you might have got some idea. Let's go ahead and see how we can do that. So to do that, we will create a table named prices, all right, or let's say it keeps, okay, and set SAS help dot cars, all right, and run. Let's look at the table, what all are the variables which needs to be kept: model, type and MSRP. Okay, here is the entire table which has all these columns. Now we just need to keep three columns: model, type and MSRP. Let's go and do that. So wherever it is outputting, here we output. So here we can just start a parenthesis operator and type keep and put the variable names whatever we want to output. All right, so what are those variables? Model, let's see again, model, type and MSRP. Close the parenthesis operator, select the statement and hit run button. Now you can see we have only three columns in the output data. So this is how you can use the keep statement. You can also try this. You can also try to put this keep statement in the set line here. It will give you the same output. You see that? So you can try this either of these two places. Now let's remove this and see what is the next option. Next option comes drop. So again here we have the entire data set of cars. Now we want to keep all the variables except few. What are those few variables which we do not want to keep? Let's look at the output. What is it that we want to output? We do not want to keep MSRP. We do not want to keep MSRP in this data. All right, so let's go ahead and see. Okay, anyway, you can populate, you can drop any of the variable whatever you want. We're not gonna observe what are the variables which are missing over here. So let's go ahead and drop. We can just create a table named drops, and in the bracket we're gonna write drop statement. Which variable we do not want to keep? MSRP. You can also type or whatever, model. Let's say I don't want to keep model. Okay, just run this. Here we have that. Now we don't have model, we don't have MSRP, etc. So this is how you can use the drop option in your SAS codes data steps. Let's look at the next. Next we have the output statement. All right, again we have this. Again we have the same cars data set, but this time you have been asked to create two output tables. One should contain the variables where the MSRP is less than $19,000. And that should have only three variables, which are model, type, and MSRP. Okay, that should keep only three variables. Now, the second table you need to create where the MSRP is greater than or equals to 19,000, but this time you should not keep these three variables, which are model, type, and MSRP. Except these three, all the variables should be there. So we are going to create these two tables. How are we going to do that? For that, we will use the output option along with if logics. Let's go ahead and see. So here in data steps, you saw that you are creating only one table based on this one table, which is cars. Now we will create, you can create as many tables as you want. I'm going to show you to create two tables, how you can create two tables from one data. First table I'm going to name price. Second table I will name as features. And as a source table, I'm going to use cars from SAS help library. All right. So for price, we have seen in the problem statement, we need to keep only three variables, which are model, type, and MSRP. So we will keep over here. Keep model, type, MSRP. And for features, we don't want to keep these three variables, but the all variables. So let's use the drop statement. Drop. Now you can see the practical example of that. We are not going to keep these three variables: model, type, and MSRP. MSRP. Okay. So these two tables will be created out of this cars. Okay. So let's go and see how we can do that. So we're gonna write if logic. In the previous videos, I have explained how you can use if. If you have not seen, just check out my previous video and the link is showing above. You can just click this link and you can watch the video. If MSRP, it says MSRP less than 19,000. If MSRP less than 19,000, then output price. Else output features and then run. So here we are saying if MSRP price is less than 19,000, then output the data in price table. If it is not, that means if the MSRP is greater than or equals to 19,000, then output the data in features table. All right, which meets to this condition. Now let's go ahead and run this. So here we have the table created. This is the price table. You can see here the table name, it says price table, and it is residing under work library because we have created a temporary table. So this has these three columns: model, type, and MSRP. This problem is solved. If you go and check in detail, it would always have the value less than 19,000. Let's look at the second table, feature. So you can see this has all the variables except model, type, and MSRP. And this table would have the value more than or greater than 19,000. But we are not keeping the MSRP price column in this table. We cannot check that. So this is how you can use the output option. Here you use the output option. Output option can be used in many conditions, right? And this is very useful. You will see how we're going to use that in the projects at the end of this entire tutorial contains. Now let's go ahead and see what we have next. Here SAS provides one option which is called underscore and underscore. This represents to the observation line. You might have noticed, if you come to this, you can see there is one more column which represents the row number. All right, 20, 19, something, something. So this is how SAS gives a default number to your tables. So that is represented by underscore and underscore. How we can use this option in our data manipulation? See this. Now let's say you have been asked to use the cars table, but, or maybe price table, but you need to output only line number 10 to 20. 10 to 20 you need to output. Let's go ahead and do that. This time we're going to use price table and create another table, which is data and P. Next table we are going to create, let's say it's line number. Line number. Okay. Then set price table. And we say if underscore and underscore greater than equals to 10 and underscore and underscore less than 20, then run. So this time we are saying, we are asking SAS to use the price table and create another table, line number, and the condition is this table should contain only those observations which are coming under a range of line number greater than or equals to 10 and less than 20. Let's go ahead and run this. So here we have the observation. So if you go and check the price table, I'm not sure if that is appearing over here. That's not coming over. If you check the price table, so, and if you go in detail, you would notice that the observations which are coming over here, these are from line number 10 to line number 20. So this is what we wanted to achieve over here. Let's go ahead and see what we have next. The obs option, observation, it stands for observation. Here it says use the price table and output only 15 observations. So when we ask here, you saw that we are asking line number 10 to 20, means we are specifying from where to where we want to output, but here we are not specifying from where. So by default SAS will take from the first to 15, and this is what output we are expecting, first observation to 15th observation. Let's go ahead and edit this, or maybe create another table, data obs, all right, and set price table, run. Where are we going to put that condition? Either you can put here or here or maybe here. At any place you can just put that. So I'm just going to put here. You can also put, sorry, here you can also say ops equals to, no, it's option, you just use that over here, ops equals to how many observations we wanted, 15. Okay, now let's run this. You can see we have the observation first to 15. All right, if you take a count, it's gonna be 15. Here it says row 1 to 15. So this is how you can use obs. Now let's go and see what we have next option. Actually, it is a miss from here. It's not obs, it's first obs. It's gonna be first obs. So how does that work? From here, we took, we asked SAS to produce 15 observations from price table. So it is starting from 1. Now, we want to say SAS, produce 15 observations, but take 15 observations for reference, but it should start from 9. Alright, so from 9 to 7th. 9 observations is starting from 7th, I'm sorry. We're gonna say SAS, produce the output and keep the observation starting from 9th observation and ends with seventh observation. Meaning, we ask SAS to not start from, we are taking just obs. Here also we are doing obs thing, but we ask SAS do not start from first, rather start from ninth. If you use only obs, starting point will be first observation. If you are using first ops, you get the option to specify where do you want SAS to start with. Okay, so let's go ahead and see how we can produce this output. Data, first ops, set, sorry, price. Please do not get confused with this table name. This can be anything, ABC and something. It could be anything. It just to so that we could keep it in mind and we do not get disconnected, I am keeping the data set name same as the option name. All right, first ops, you can put as many as you want, and then run. Here let's start. We say ops 15th, but we want you to start from 7. Okay, now let's go and run this. Here you can see that, oops, looks like there is something wrong. Okay, here we got some problem. Let's go to the code and modify this. Rather than putting this over here, we need to use this with set statement because we need to specify in the source data. So here we are asking to pick only 15 observation, but this time do not start from first, from line number one. Rather, you make seventh line as the first observation. Now after doing this, just select it and hit run button. So there we go, we have the output which we wanted over here. All right, thank you very much for watching the video. Wish you very good luck.